Hey, today I'm going to show you how to upgrade your MacBook with an NVMe drive. Those are very fast, they can speed up your system significantly, and they have become pretty cheap, so yeah, let's get started. First of all, you have to make sure that you are running at least High Sierra. In my case, I'm running Mojave. And the only additional thing you need is a small M.2 adapter. I'll link those in the description, and we can start by downloading macOS from the App Store. As soon as this screen pops up, we continue by formatting our USB drive. It has to be at least 8 GB. For that, we are going into Disk Utility, we are going to select the flash storage and click on Erase, select macOS Extended Journaled and call it macUSB like this. Next up, we are going into Terminal, and we are going to paste this command from the description. And if you didn't call your USB stick macUSB, you have to edit it accordingly. This is going to take around 5 minutes, so grab a coffee and sit back. If you don't want to mess around with Terminal, there is another way. You can use this app, I'll link in the description, and it's basically just two clicks and it does the same thing, but I like to do things the old-fashioned way, and I don't know if this is going to be online when you're watching this video, so yeah, Terminal is always the best way to do it. Either way, we are finished preparing, so we can turn off the computer now and get started. Alright, to start off, we are going to remove all the screws from the backplate. It's also a good idea to keep track of which screw goes where, because some might be longer than others. Keep in mind that those are pentalobe 5 screws and not torx. And then you can easily lift off the back panel. Next up, you have to make sure that your power supply is not connected, and then you push on the little plastic tab on the battery connector to disconnect it. Now you're going to need a Torx 5 screwdriver and unmount the old SSD. And then gently lift up the drive and pull it out sideways. Alright, now this little guy will come into play, and I applied some Kapton tape to it. You can use any ESD tape. I think Kapton tape is the best because it's very temperature resistant. Taping the adapter is optional, but it's good practice and it shields against interference. And now you just have to slide the adapter into the SSD slot. Next up, your drive goes right into it, and don't use too much force. You will know it's inserted correctly when the mounting holes line up. Now you just need to screw in the T5 screw. Make sure it's not too tight, finger tight is more than enough. And finally, you are going to need to reconnect the battery. Now just put the back case back together and we can get started on the new system. For that, we are going to boot while pressing the Option key. And after hearing the chime, you will see a selection of your newly created USB drive. We are going to select that and wait for the setup to boot. Now you choose the language of your choice. And here you are going to select disk utility. As you can see here, the drive got discovered. So we are going to select erase. Here you are going to choose either APFS or APFS encrypted. And as for the partition scheme, we are going to use GUID. And that's basically it. You can choose now if you want to do a fresh install of macOS or if you want to restore from your Time Machine. In my case, I'm using a Time Machine backup from my Raspberry Pi. I also got a video on that. So I'm just gonna skip ahead here and come back when the system boots. Alright, now this step only applies if you have a Mac that is older than 2015. You will need to open terminal and type sudo pmset-a standby 0, auto power off 0, and hibernate mode 0. And that's it, you have a blazing fast NVMe inside your MacBook now. I'm just gonna show you some benchmark. On the left hand side we have my old Apple SSD, and while it's not horribly slow, it's certainly not up to par with today's standards, and we basically tripled our speed, and in my case storage as well, for under 200 bucks. This is especially apparent when booting the device or running programs like Creative Suite from Adobe, you will notice the drastic increase of speed. Also, I might want to add that I'm using a MacBook Air from 2013 here, and that one only has PCIe 2.0, so if you have, for example, a Retina MacBook Pro from 2015, you are going to have full PCIe 3.0 speeds, and those are in the range of 3 gigabytes per second. What you might want to keep in mind is that some NVMe drives, like the Samsung Evo or Pro, are quite known for that. They do need more power to work, so you might see a battery life decrease of about 15%. But that's not too bad, considering that your computer will complete tasks faster. A personal recommendation would be the Intel 760p. That one is almost as fast as the recent Evo from Samsung, and it has very low power consumption. So to sum it up, installing an NVMe drive is definitely one of the few things you can do with MacBooks that are not too ancient, and I highly recommend it. Basically, there's not a single upgrade that will get you this much performance at this price point. Alright, so feel free to try it out yourself, and if you run into any issue, just comment below. Thanks for watching, and have a good one.